Welcome to my channel. It's Jeannie, and I'm really happy to see you here, and I appreciate you coming to my channel. If it's your first time here, welcome, and if you're coming back, thank you. I really do appreciate you. Tonight, I am going to be making a lot of crinkly, tingly, scratchy sounds that hopefully will help you to relax and clear your mind from all the day's noises, all the day's thoughts, and you can lie back, relax, and hopefully fall asleep. There'll be some soft-spoken chit-chat, but nothing too important. So just listen to my voice and listen to the sounds and relax and just let peace and tingles take over your entire body, your entire mind, and just shut down and relax. Relax. So, here we go. Okay, welcome, welcome, welcome. It's time to tune out and relax and forget about the day and just let all the sounds you hear make you feel more and more relaxed and sleepy. Yes, I have two different color nail polishes on. I wasn't sure which one I liked. And I didn't return to finish. So, which one do you like? First thing I want to show you is something you've seen before, my trusty umbrella. It is such a nice crinkly, silky sound. when I was a little girl. And like many children of my era, we took rugs to school in kindergarten to lie down on at nap time. And it was a nice little rest. I don't think they do that anymore, but I looked forward to it. And one of the reasons why is because my teacher, and back then all female teachers had to wear dresses, she also wore, I guess it was a girdle and a slip, and when she would walk around, it would kind of make this sound. And it gave me tingles. I loved taking naps on those rugs on the hard floor. I don't know how long the naps were for, maybe 15, 20 minutes, maybe. I don't know. I don't remember. But I looked forward to them. During afternoon naps, I loved hearing the small airplanes fly over our house. That soft, droning buzz. I often wondered where they were going, what they were doing. And to this day, if I'm taking a break during the day, and I hear a small airplane in the distance, it reminds me of when I was a little girl. And it's a good feeling. It's a good memory. A relaxing memory. the next item I have to show you, and it actually gives me tingles when I go through it. I have these buttons, but I also have these really old buttons. And I think I got them at a garage sale many years ago. And some of them I don't know that I would ever use. But I have some just in case. The prices on them are quite interesting. 70 cents, 40 cents. Buttons aren't that cheap today. 60 cents. Look at these metal buttons for 40 cents. We used to have a button jar when I was a young child. It was just a great big mason jar full of buttons. I never understood that. How on earth did someone lose that many buttons? Would we ever need to replace that many buttons? And I don't think I ever saw my mom put a button on anything for anyone except an outfit maybe she made me. These are pretty. Oh, and this is a beautiful one. There's only one. And these have a piece of wood in them. Four. These are great. I don't know if you can see that the centers are a cut out star. Some that are not on cards. I like these metallic ones. Looks like tree of life almost, with roots that go far and wide, and branches that go far and wide. But I don't think that's what it is. Oh, and here's another one. Have a design on them as well. These little, oh, it's a bird. Yeah, it's a bird with its wings spread. Looks like I have three of those. Styled in Hollywood. Wow, 29 cents. These are starlet buttons. These are very mid-century modern, very mod, groovy, huh? See a lot of buttons like these today. 70 cents. Let's see how they're a double layer. Oh, these are pretty. They look like stone. But they're plastic. These are just regular buttons. Nothing fancy about them. Just very plain. So, now the next item, don't laugh, don't judge, but we've been collecting for a long, long time. Corks from bottles of wine that we've had. Now, remember, this is probably 25 years worth of wines, not last week's. I'm also a winemaker, and I taste a lot of different wines from all over the world. And some of these are very old. And I want you to know, this is only a fraction of what I have collected. I'm saving them to do a cork project, and it will be a big one. I have not decided on the theme. Maybe the initial B. I don't know. Do you have any ideas or suggestions? Corks are very interesting. You should Google what it looks like to be punching holes in the cork tree skins to get these. And not all corks are the same. Some of them are pure cork, and some of them are an amalgamation, a combination. This is not cork at all. This is synthetic. The nice thing about a cork, or one of the benefits of a cork to some wines, not all, is it allows for micro oxygenation, which over time can improve the quality of a wine. Oxygen can also ruin a wine, so there has to be enough SO2 or sulfur dioxide to protect the wine and buffer a little bit against some of that oxygenation, but it's an interesting science. And not all corks, as you can see, are even the same size or shape. This is a 1998, so that's already 22 years old, 24 years old. So that's how long we've been collecting these. Chateau de Rignac. We have a lot of French wines, Italian wines, and of course California wines, as well as Chile, New Zealand, although New Zealand is pretty much screw caps right now. Here's a 1997 Chateau de Grand Chambellan. 1997. Wow. This one is signed or written on. It says 1999 Thanksgiving. California wines really got put on the map by an event called the Judgment of Paris. It's an amazing story, and you should Google it if you want to learn more about it. But it was a blind tasting test brought from these wines that this English winemaker, this English vintner brought back from California and put up against some French wines. And all the judges were French, and they thought hands down the wines they were tasting were French. And they were, in fact, California wines. I believe Stag's Leap was one. And Chateau Montelena, the 1973 Chardonnay, one also. And several others. And it just shocked the world that California was coming out with wines that surpassed, based on these judges, the French wines. and it was almost scandalous. So it's a great story. There was a movie made about it, but it was very Hollywoodized and dramatized in a way that had nothing to do with the facts of what really happened. And it would be worth reading about. I think even Wikipedia has a good synopsis of what happened. It's called The Judgment of Paris. This, of course, is for a sparkling wine, and it says here méthode traditionnelle, and that means the way they make the champagne, if it's from Champagne, or the sparkling wine, is the traditional method, not just adding carbonation at the end. But it's quite a process, and but better quality when you see méthode traditionnelle. For you golfers, Greg Norman wine. This is Australian. See that symbol? He had that on his shirt and his hats and his clothing. That was his, what was he called? The great white shark or something like that. I'm a winemaker, and I do winemaking for private label wines, and it's an amazing science, more than I ever thought when I went into it. It's just an amazing, amazing science, and it is a science. Here's a 2000. Here's a 98. La vie betro, Chateau La vie betro. Last month for my birthday, one of our daughters got us a bottle of wine. It was a 2,800-acre Cabernet Sauvignon. Google that bad boy. It was amazing. One of the best wines I've ever had. Like to get my hands on more. Here's a Duckhorn. We like Duckhorn. 2001. Trefethen. Trefethen is a great, not only winery, but a great vineyard. A lot of what you see on the Napa Valley floor is Trefethen vineyards. And a lot of the wineries in Napa actually buy grapes from them to supplement what they either grow or what they buy from other growers. A lot of people don't realize that not every winery has its own vineyard. Some wineries get their grapes from various vineyards depending on what they're looking to make. Wow, that is a beautiful cork. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? It's a 2005. Look how short and fat this cork is. This is Fat Bastard Wine Company. Duckhorn portfolio, I believe. Hess. And of course, bubble wrap. this has been a very relaxing video for you to listen to. It's hard to watch videos and keep your eyes open. But if you have headphones or AirPods or earbuds, you can just close your eyes and listen and just tune out of life. So, I hope you are relaxed, falling asleep, and going into a dream world. I appreciate you so much, and I thank you for being with me tonight. I'm being invaded by my three cats who were able to open the door. But they came in right at the right time. I'll see you in the next video.